the energy quadrant today, crude oil actually took a pretty substantial hit. It was down over 6%. But when you look at it from a high to a low, it doesn't look like that big of a deal. It really went from 24.65 on the high side down to 22.38 on the low side, and actually finished kind of in the middle of that range on the WTI futures. But when you get to these kind of price levels, obviously $2 is a 10% of 22. It's approximately 10%. So when you get moves like this, you get these exaggerated percentage moves. Down 6.3% on the day in the close today. And in the month of March so far, again, because of the low prices we're at, we've had 9 moves of 5% or more. So these percentages matter. But if you're looking at the futures as a product, you're still looking at that same tick value, and the moves aren't that dramatic from a tick perspective. But again, down 6.3% today. Part of the reason is with the passage of the rescue bill, that over $2 trillion bill that went to the Senate. It hasn't passed the House yet. It hasn't landed on the president's desk, but it did get through the hard part, which was the Senate, and it got through it unanimously, which leads you to believe that it's going to get through the House and be signed by the president. There's no money allocated for refilling the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. That was something President Trump said he was going to do. He was going to fill the SPR to the top, but the money was not allocated in this rescue bill because one side wanted the equivalent amount of funding for green energy products, and they just couldn't agree that that was how it was going to be, so they took them both out. So there's no funding, so they've withdrawn their tender. 4 barrels in the Strategic Petroleum Reserve got a little bit extended sell-off when that happened. Most of that came back later in the day. And then lastly, the head of the EIA made a comment today saying basically that he sees demand falling by 20 million barrels a day when this economic crisis actually filters all the way through to the general economy, which again is likely to keep a lid, for lack of a stronger word, on crude oil prices in the near future.